Good morning, students. Today's topic is about plant ecology, principles of ecology. Ecology is a division of biology which deals with the study of environment in relation to organism. So ecology means organism and its surrounding environment. It can be studied by considering individual organisms, population, community or biome or biosphere and their environment. So it can be studied by considering individual organisms, population, community, biome or biosphere and their environment. Ecology is essentially a practical science which involving experiments, continuous observation to predict how organisms react to particular environmental circumstance and understanding the principles involved in ecology. The term ecology is derived from two Greek words, oikos, which means house or dwelling place, that is living place of an organism, and logos means study. It was first proposed by Ritter in the year 1868. The most widely accepted definition of ecology was given by Ernst Haeckel in the year 1869. Alexander von Humboldt is considered as a father of ecology. Eugene P. Odom is a father of modern ecology. R. Misra is considered to be a father of Indian ecology. Definitions of ecology. According to Ritter, the study of living organisms, both plants and animals, in their natural habitats or homes. So Ritter, in the year 1885, defined the ecology of a living organism as a study of living organism, both plants and animals, in their natural habitats or house. Ernst Haeckel, in the year 1889, ecology is the study of the reciprocal relationship between living and their environments, that is living things and non-living things. The next, ecological hierarchy. So the ecological hierarchy deals with individual organism, population, a group of population make community, ecosystem, landscape, biome and biosphere. This is the hierarchy of ecology. The interaction of organism with their environment result in the establishment of grouping of organism, which is called a ecological hierarchy or ecological levels of organization. The basic unit of ecological hierarchy is an individual organism. An individual organisms grouped together to make the population. Population makes community and community makes ecosystem, then landscape, biome and biosphere. The next, branches of ecology. Ecology is mainly divided into two branches. They are art ecology and syn ecology. Art ecology is the study of an individual species and is called as species ecology. So the art ecology deals with the ecology of an individual species, single species, and is also called as a species ecology. What are species? The species are the basic unit of classification. For example, human being, Homo sapiens, are a species. So that is the ecology which deals about a individual species is called as a art ecology. The next, syn ecology. Syn ecology is the ecology of a population or community with one or more species and also called as a community ecology. Action ecology is also called as a community ecology because it deals with the ecology of a community with one or more species, many advances and development in the field of ecology resulting in various branches such as molecular ecology, ecotechnology, statistical ecology and environmental toxicology. The next, habitat and niche. Habitat is a specific physical place, a locality occupied by an organism or any species which has a particular combination of abiotic or environmental factor. But the environment of any community is called as a biotope. So the habitat is a specific physical place, this living place or a locality occupied by an organism. Niche. An ecological niche refers to an organism place in the biotic environment and its functional role in an ecosystem. The term niche was first coined by the naturalist Johnson, Roosevelt Hill Johnson and Grinnell in the year 1917 was probably the first to use the term niche. The habitat and a niche of any organism is called ecotope. So what does mean by ecotope? The habitat and niche of any organism is called a ecotope. Next, difference between habitat and niche. Habitat is a specific place, there is specific physical space occupied by an organism, that is species. Niche, a functional space occupied by an organism in the same ecosystem. Same habitat may be shared by many organisms. A single niche is occupied by a single species. Habitat specificity is established by organism. Niche, organism may change their niche with the time and season. Example for habitat is grassland, lake ecosystem, stream ecosystem are some of the example for habitat. Example for niches, birds in New Zealand and niches of panda. So these are the some example for a niche. The next, ecological equivalence. Ecological equivalence, taxonomically different species occupying similar habitat, that niches in different geographical regions are called as ecological equivalence. That is, the similar habitat, that is similar living place is shared by different species. For example, in forest ecosystem, there are different varieties of species are there. All are occupied in the same habitat, that is forest. It is called as a ecological equivalence. Examples for ecological equivalence. Certain species or epiphytic orchids of Western Ghats of India differ from the epiphytic orchids of Southern America. But they all are epiphytes. What are called epiphytes? The epiphytes of the plants which lives on the other plants only for the purpose of shelter. It does not get any food or water from the host plant or the foreign plant. So example for ecological equivalent is the epiphytes of orchids of Western Ghats of India differ from the epiphytes orchids of Southern America, but all of them are same species, that is epiphytes. Some of the grasslands of Western Ghats of India differ from the grass species of temperate grassland of steppe in North America, but they are ecological primary producers and fulfilling similar roles in the respective communities. But all are involved in photosynthesis and prepare their food, but they are having a different type of a different in their nature. That is ecosystem. Ecological factors. many organisms coexist in the environment. The environment that is surrounding, which includes physical, chemical and biological components. When a component surrounding an organism affects the life of an organism, it becomes a factor. All such a factor together are called as a environmental factors. So the factors which are present in the surrounding, which affects the life of an organism, is called as a environmental factors or ecological factors. These factors can be classified into two. One is living factor and non-living. These factors can be classified into two. One is the living factor and non-living factor. The living factor are called as a biotic factor, and the non-living factors are called as a abiotic factor, which makes the environment of an organism. However, the ecological factors are meaningfully grouped into four classes. They are climatic factor, edaphic factor, topographic factors, biotic factors. First one is a climatic factor. The climate is one of an important natural factor that controlling the plant's life. The climatic factors include light, temperature, water, wind and fire. First one is light. The light is a well-known factor needed for the basic physiological process of plant, such as photosynthesis, transpiration and germination and flowering. So the light plays very important role in the plant's life for photosynthesis, transpiration, germination, that is seed germination and flowering. The portion of the sunlight which can be resolved by the human eye is called a visible light. So the light which can be seen through our naked eye is called as a visible light. The visible part of the light is made up of wavelength from about 400 nanometer, that is violet color, to 700 nanometer, red color. The rate of photosynthesis is maximum at blue, 400 to 500 nanometer, and red 600 to 700 nanometer. The green 500 to 600 nanometer wavelength of spectrum is less strongly observed by plants. So the rate of photosynthesis is maximum at blue and red light. It is less in the green light. The next effect of light on the